Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's get focused this morning. Hallelujah. Come on. God is good, and God is good all the time, and God is faithful. We give God the honor, the glory, the praise, the name, the fame. It belongs to Him. Hallelujah. Amen. We take none of the glory. As a matter of fact, no flesh shall glory in His presence. You know, we give Him all the fame. It belongs to Him. Hallelujah. We lift Him up. We magnify Him. John the Baptist was the greatest prophet. Amen. And he said, when Jesus came on the scene, he said, I must decrease, He must increase. This morning we lift up the name of Jesus. And if He be lifted up, guess what? He will draw all men unto Him. And so we thank God for the Spirit of God. We thank God for the anointing of God. We thank God for the Word of God this morning. Hallelujah. Well, this morning we give God the glory, we give God the honor, and we give Him the praise. Come on, lift your hands and tell God thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All right, let's tune in. Amen. Get a friend, get a member of the family, and let's focus this morning. Let's share this Facebook post. Amen. And encourage others to tune in. I've got a word from the Lord. We got a powerful worship this morning. Amen. We thank God that we're still following the guidelines. Amen. Like I said, we're not fearful, but we are careful. We use wisdom. We use practical things as children of God. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm excited to be in the house of the Lord today. Amen. A year ago, this time, we were doing the service from the home, from my living room. But I just love God's house and God's presence this morning. Amen. At this time, before we get into a time of praise and worship, we want to get into a time of prayer. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And we have our Deacon Ivan. Let's just stand in the house of the Lord today. Glory to God. Glory to God. Deacon Ivan will come at this time, and he will take us to the throne of grace and lead us in a time of prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. God is good, and God is good all the time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. It is good to be in the house of the Lord this morning, ladies and gentlemen. Last week, about the same time, I was home. I was hurting, but my God is good.
Yes, sir.
This morning, I can stand in His presence and declare the wonderful works of the Lord. And it's good to be here in His presence, I must say. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know, those present and those watching via YouTube, whatever your form of media this morning, God is alive. He is great, and He is great to be praised. So this morning, wherever you are, just take that moment out to just praise Him for all the wondrous things He has done. Oh, what a wonderful God, I must say this morning, O Lord Jesus Christ. In spite of the circumstances around us, O Lord God, You stand victorious this morning, O Lord God. Oh, God, O Lord Jesus, we cry out to You because You are the I am that I am this morning, O Lord God. Father, no one comes close to You this morning, O Lord God Jesus. You just speak the word and it is done immediately, O Lord God Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, You continue to open the windows of heaven and pour the mighty blessing upon Your people, O Lord God Jesus. Not trying to be selfish this morning, O Father, Lord God. But look down upon 1673 Dean Street, O Lord God Jesus. As we stand in Your presence, O Father, Lord God. Under Your mild servant, Apostle Lucian Rojas, O Lord God. And Chatian Rojas this morning, O Father, Lord God. Father, Lord, You continue to give them the tools to use, O Father, to further Your word, O Lord Jesus. Oh, Father, move by Your Spirit this morning, O God Jesus. Father, continue to open up the windows of heaven, O Father, and pour Your mighty blessings upon them, O Lord God. Oh, yes, Father, Lord God. I can feel Your presence in here this morning, O Lord God. I can feel breakthrough in the room this morning, O Lord God, Jesus. There's healing in the room this morning, oh Lord God. And Father, I just want to lift Pastor Paul before you right now, oh Lord God Jesus. Father, Lord, you know he'll be in the house this morning, oh Father, Lord God. But the enemy has attacked his back this morning, oh Lord God. But Father, you said this morning is healing in the room, oh Father. Reach your hand, oh Lord God, right now.
Yes, Lord.
Touch that back, oh Father, Lord Jesus. Touch his spine, oh Father, Lord God. Whatever is not right, fix it. In no other name but your name this morning, oh Lord God. Father, touch Pastor Ken this morning, oh Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Father, Lord, you know you played an integral part in building this Ephesus, oh Lord God, that we can come and worship Lord God Jesus. Father, Lord, he might be down this morning, but he's not out because why? We have a Redeemer in Jesus Christ this morning, oh Lord God. Father, Lord, touch Brother Muhammad this morning, oh
yes,
Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
Father, Lord, you have saved his life. Father, he's a living testimony of your greatness, your mercy, your love, oh Lord God Jesus. But the enemy continues to say, prove me. But I want you to know this morning, Brother Muhammad, that God is the giver of life. And no one can take it from you but Jesus Christ of Nazareth this morning. Oh, Lord God, saying this morning, there's breakthrough in the room this morning, oh, Lord God. Whatever you're going through this morning, Lord is saying, I can sustain you. Put your eyes on me. Put your whole being on me and I will prove you that I am the I am that I am this morning, Lord God Jesus. Oh, Father, Lord, Lord, you touch the members of this house, oh, Lord God. Especially those in leadership, Father, the pastors, oh, Lord.
Yes.
Pastor Claudette Scott, Father, Lord God. Pastor Brown, oh, Lord God. Pastor Cruz, oh, Father. Pastor Paul, oh, Lord God. The leadership of this house, oh, Lord. Apostle Lucien Rojas and Kathy Ann Rojas,
yes,
oh,
Lord.
Lord God. Touch every member, oh, Lord God. Young and old, oh, Father, Lord, you continue to instill in them that will, oh Father, to travail, oh Lord God. In your word say, yeah, I go through the shadow of the death, oh Lord God. I will fear no evil, because thou art with me, oh Lord God. Father, Lord, I ask that you continue to be with us, oh Lord,
yes,
Father,
yes.
Lord God. Be with us in our going out and our coming in, oh Father, Lord God. All good things come from you this morning, oh Lord God. Father, I give you the honor, the glory, and the praise, oh, Father, Lord God. Father, Lord, touch the musicians this morning, oh, Father, Lord God. A special touch, oh, Father, Lord God, on Pastor Cujo, oh, Father, as he leads us in your worship and praise this morning, oh, Lord God. Father, Lord, you are a person who admires worship, oh, Lord God. You said, put the worshipers in the front, oh, Lord God.
Jesus.
Today we put the cavalry, the military, the Marine Corps in front. But you said, put the worshipers in front, oh Lord God. Because you have that desire, that love, that zeal for worship. He said, ah, if you don't worship me, the rocks will worship me. He said, everything that have breath, praise thee the Lord, oh Lord God Jesus. Touch the audio team this morning, oh Father, Lord God.
Hey, hallelujah.
Father, as they send this viral, oh Lord God, Jesus, across the airwaves, oh Father. Touch them, oh Father, that as collectively as a body, oh Father, Lord God, people will come to know the signature behind it, oh Lord God, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, Lord, we're not here to give them accolades, oh, Father. All accolades, all promotions come from you this morning. All I ask of them is to humble themselves, be servants of you, oh, Lord God, Jesus. And you will establish their course, oh, Father, Lord God. Father, Lord God, I commence the service into your hands, oh, Father. Father, whatever is done, whatever is said, oh, Father, Lord, is to bring honor and glory to your marvelous name this morning. And again, we, of the people of International Christian Center, just want to say, we love you, we honor you, and we give you the praise in Jesus' mighty name.
Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Deacon Eiffel. Amen. For that prayer this morning. Hallelujah. We thank God. Men ought to always ought to pray and not to faint. And we give God the glory this morning. Hallelujah. All right. We want you to tune in. Hallelujah. All right. And we want to get ready for a time of praise, a time of worship, as we lift up the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Pastor Kojo and the team will take us into God's presence. Let's rejoice in the Lord. Let's magnify the Lord and be glad this morning in the wonderful name of Jesus. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody give the Lord a praise offering in this house.
Yes.
Oh, it's so good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. His name is worthy to be exalted. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The song says, I am a friend of God. He has called me friend. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Who am I that you are mindful of me? How you hear me when I call, when I call.
Yeah, come on, come on.
Is it true that you are thinking of me?
Uh-huh.
How you love me. It's amazing. It's amazing. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God.
Oh yes.
He calls me holy. He calls me sanctified. We bless your name this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship you, oh God. We honor your name today, Jesus. And you deserve the glory and the honor
and the honor.
Come on.
As we lift our hands and worship,
and we bless,
as we bless your holy,
you deserve the glory.
Hallelujah. There is no one else. We worship you. You are great. We give you glory.
You do miracles.
Oh, yes.
where you are, just worship.
Hey.
Worship the Lord.
We magnify the Lord.
Worship the Lord.
We bless the Lord.
He's great.
Hallelujah.
He's great.
Hallelujah.
He's great.
Hallelujah.
He's great.
He's great.
You're great,
Lord. You're great, Lord. You are great, Lord. You are great.
He's great.
You are great. You are great. You are great. You are great, Lord. Come on, come on, lift your hands and give God the glory. You are great God, you're awesome God. There is none beside you. You are eternal. You are invisible. You are immortal. You are the only wise God. You are God and beside you, there is none other. You are God all by yourself. You answer to no one. You are held accountable to no one. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the beginning and the end. You are the first and the last. You was, you is, and you is to come. Oh yes. But you are great. You do miracles. Not in the olden day, but you still do miracles today. Oh, hallelujah. There is no one else like you. Hey, 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 hey. For you are great.
Great.
You do miracles
so great.
You parted
the Red
Sea.
No one
you struck the lion's
like
mouth.
You.
You are a miracle working God.
There is no one else like you.
Oh,
for you are great. You do miracles
oh, yes,
so
Lord.
Great. There is no one else like you.
Oh, hallelujah. We serve a God that's alive and well this morning in the wonderful name of Jesus. You may be seated at this time. I just thank God for the spirit that is in this house today. I am so delighted. I'm so happy. I'm so blessed this morning to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Before I go into the word of God today, we have our dear brother with us. He will come forth at this time. Before I go into God's word, and he will bless our heart, amen, in song. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, help me to welcome this morning our dear psalmist, three-time McDonald Gospel winner, sang for the president, sang at the White House, sang all over the world. We have with us this morning our dear brother Gerard Placid. Would he come and minister? God bless you, sir. God bless you, sir. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory
God
to
is God. Good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Praise the Lord. Just before I go into the song, I want to continue to thank Pastor Rojas and his wife and to you, the members of ICC. And would like you to join me and my son next week during church, where we both will be celebrating our birthdays on Sunday, May 2nd. All right. I don't need another gift other than that gift, Pastor Rojas. There's a picture I will show you after church, and it brought me to tears when Pastor Gerard was singing, "You Are Great," and just to watch Gerard and stuff with his eyes closed, you will see it. It will send chills through your body. But for me, you know, the Bible says that a child will lead them. And indeed, my son has done so much for me. We made a 28-hour journey to Atlanta on Monday, driving. It took us a whole week. But it gave me an opportunity to really bond with my son. And I give God praise. 3 weeks, I'm graduating my second degree, and I am just honored. So I want to do this song, which was one of the songs from my first album, and it talks about that five-letter word called grace. G-R-A-C-E. God's righteousness at Christ's expense. Were it not for grace.
Time measured out my days, life carried me along. In my soul I've yearned to follow God.
Send him.
But I knew I'd never be so strong. I looked out at this world to learn how heaven could be gained. Just to end where I began, where human effort is all in vain. Were it not for grace, I can tell you where I'd be, wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. The battles I would face, expressed with all my heart, offered to a friend who took my place and ran a course I could not stop. But when he saw in full just how much love his love would cost, my God spent the final mile between me and heaven so I would not be lost. Were it not for grace, I can tell you where wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go.
I know how that would go.
The battles I would face, but losing the race, were it not for grace.
Awesome, awesome, was it not for grace? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that soothing? So beautiful. If it was not for the grace of God, but for the grace of Almighty God. Hallelujah. And this morning, I want to touch a little bit on that this morning, even though I did not concur with Jared concerning that subject. But this morning, I want to climax a message on the blessings, amen, the blessings of the Lord. In the book of Proverbs, it says that the blessings of the Lord in Proverbs 10 and 22, it says the blessings of the Lord make it rich and addeth no sorrow with it. And I thank God for the blessings. Amen. We thank God for the blessings. And so we see that how God in the beginning, stay with me everyone, in the beginning, how God blessed man. When he made man, God blessed him in Genesis. God blessed him and God empowered him. Not only did he empower him, but God also established him. God equipped him. Hallelujah. And we see how man was really walking in the blessings of Almighty God. But when man disobeyed God and man sinned, man fell from grace. And so we needed a redeemer to redeem us from the curse. Amen. So I believe, hear me. I believe right now in this day and age, in this dispensation, we are not cursed, but we are blessed. We hear the term generational curses and how the father ate sour grapes and the children's teeth is set on edge. But if you read Ezekiel 18, it talks about things that you can do to liberate yourself from the curse. I believe as a child of God that is born again, accept the Lord as our personal savior, we are not cursed. He died, he took the curse upon himself that we may be free and that we may be blessed. So therefore, 1 Corinthians 5 and 17 says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. The old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Now we are walking in newness of life. Now we are walking in grace. Amen. Now we are not under the law anymore, but we are under grace. And we thank God for that song, Pastor Jared, but for the grace. Amen. And so we see how the Lord decided to bless. Amen. To bless. And under the law, we were cursed. But under grace, the curse is reversed and the curse is canceled. Now, if you're not in Christ, you can still be inheriting some curses. But once you accept Christ, amen, the curse is broken. You say, oh, I don't believe that. Well, I believe as a child, don't tell me Christ died on the cross, shed his blood for me, and I'm still cursed. Now, if you're not saved, now the Bible says, whatever man sow, that shall he reap. And I want to take my time this morning, and I want to show you how God is in the blessing business. And it started with Abraham. And I know I gave you the scripture before, and I will give it to you again. Genesis 12:1-5. I want to look for 1 minute at Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph. How the blessing flowed from the father to the son, to the grandson, to the great grandson. Amen. And I believe blessing can be passed on. The Bible said a good man leave an inheritance for his children's children. This morning I speak a blessing over your life in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare you are blessed and not cursed. You are above and not beneath. You are the head and not the tail. You are a winner and not a loser. You are a victor and not a victim. Hallelujah. So the Lord called Abraham. Now the Lord said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, thy kindred, and from thy father's house unto a land which I will show thee. Verse 2. And watch this. And I will make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee. I will do what? Bless thee, and thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. I can stop right there. I will bless you. I will bless you. I will bless you, Abraham, and I will make you a blessing. Every day you should try to be a blessing to somebody. Be a blessing and not a burden. In your going out and in your coming in, be a blessing to your family. Be a blessing to your community. Be a blessing to your church. Be a blessing to your ministry. Be a blessing wherever you go. Everywhere your feet shall tread, let it be yours. Amen. We thank God for kingdom blessing and kingdom authority. The Lord called Abraham and he blessed him. And he didn't only bless him, but he said, I will make you a blessing. Hallelujah. Make me a blessing, Lord. Make me a blessing, Lord. Make me a blessing, Lord. This morning, I am a blessing to you. I'm speaking God's word. Hallelujah. And I will what? Make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee. All right. And shall be a blessing. Verse 3. And I will bless them that bless thee. That's favor. That's favor. I will bless them. To bless is to confer or to invoke divine favor upon. And somebody once said favor is not fear. But the favor of God is upon you. The favor of God is upon me. How many can look back at your life and remember and look at ways how God has blessed you? The mere fact that you are above ground is a blessing. Do you know COVID has taken out over 3 million people? Over half a million people in the United States of America. And somehow you have survived. You are a survivor. You're still here. The Bible said, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Don't take things for granted. The blessings of the Lord. I will bless them that bless you. I will curse them that curse you. And in thee shall all families of the earth be blessed. Abraham was loaded with purpose and destiny. Father Abraham, what a patriot. Father Abraham, what a blessing. And the blessing didn't only flow to our Father Abraham, but it flowed to Isaac. Hallelujah. It flowed to Isaac. Let's look at Genesis 26. Okay. Now there was a farming in the land beside the first farming that was in the days of Abraham. And Isaac went unto Abimelech, king of the Philistine, and unto Gerard. Almost said Gerard. And the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down unto Egypt, dwell in the land which I shall tell thee of. How many believe in the direction of God, the leading of God, the hands of God? Sojourn in this land, and I will be with thee. And what? I will bless thee. And will do what? Hallelujah. For unto thee and unto thy seed, I will give these countries, and I will perform the oath which I swear unto Abraham thy father. Glory to God. And I will make thy seed to multiply as the stars of heaven, and will give unto thee thy seed all these countries, and in thy seed shall all the nation of the earth be blessed. Because that Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge, my commandment, my statutes, and my laws. So because Abraham obeyed God, the blessing flowed from Abraham unto Isaac. Hallelujah. Then from Isaac, it went on to Jacob. Hallelujah. And boy, Jacob was blessed. I shared on last week how Isaac blessed Jacob. instead of Esau. And now, not only Abraham was blessed and Isaac was blessed, now Jacob was blessed. Let's look at Genesis chapter 30 and 27 through 30. Hallelujah. And Laban said to him, you know who was Laban? That was his uncle slash father-in-law. I pray thee, if I found favor in thy eyes, tarry, for I have learned by my experience that the Lord had blessed me for thy sake. How many know the Lord can bless you if you hang around blessed people? That's true. That's powerful. Hallelujah. There is something about your associates. If you hang around nine broke people, it is quite possible, the law of probability, you might be number 10. Show me your friends and I'll show you your future. Hang around successful people. Hang around progressive people. And more than likely, that spirit will transfer, or that spirit will rub off on you. So when Jacob aligned himself to his uncle Laban, the blessings begin to flow because as a result of Jacob. And he said, don't go, stay with me. And he said, appoint me thy wage and I will give it to you. Call the shots. You two of a value. You two valuable. And that's what I tell people in life. No matter where you go, always try to add value. Let people miss you. Hallelujah. And he said unto him, thou knowest that I have served thee and how thy cattle was with me. And verse 30. For it was little which thou had before I came, and it is now increased into a multitude. And the Lord had blessed thee since my coming. And now, when I shall provide for my own household also. So I came to you, and from the moment I came to you, I was better to you than 10 sons. From the moment I came to you, your livestock increased. From the moment I came to you, things begin to prosper. From the moment I'm aligned myself with you, I came with good qualities. I had a good attitude. I had a positive attitude. And the moment I align myself with you, things begin to prosper. Things begin to increase. Things begin to grow. Hallelujah. Jacob was blessed. And as a result of that, the people around him enjoy the blessings. Hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. So we see Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Watch this. And now we see Joseph. Joseph aligned himself to Potiphar. And again, Potiphar experienced the blessing. Because blessing flows from the head to the beard to the skirt. So if you're sitting under a blessed man or a blessed woman, if you are associated with blessed people, blessings have a way of flowing. Blessings has a way of vibrating. Blessings has a way of creating waves and energy. Because, amen, the circle is blessed. Hallelujah. See what happened. Look at Genesis again. Genesis, what is this? 37 and 5. Oh, it's not 37. Is it 39? I think I give you the wrong scripture here. I think it's 39. Let's see what 39 says. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Sorry about that. But the thing was, because Joseph was aligned with Potiphar. Let me see if I get that scripture here quickly. Wow, yes, that's what it was. And it came to pass from the time he had made him overseer over in his house and over all that he had, the Lord did what? Blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. Hallelujah. 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 And the blessings of the Lord was upon all that he had in the house and in the field. Look at the transformation. Look at the transition. Look how the blessings was flowing. So now these men were blessed. But we was doing a study on Friday night. We talk about the law came through Moses, but grace and truth came through Christ. Amen. So now we see, because Adam and Eve sinned, that curse had to be broken, that curse had to be reversed, that curse had to be canceled, and so we needed a savior to redeem us from the curse of that law. Now I want to say this with you. A blessing is conditional, but the love of God is not conditional. I love my children. And my love for them is based on the fact that I'm their father. No, that will not change. Whether they disappoint me, whether they succeed, whether they fail, I still love them because why? They are my children. Now I can be disappointed. No, I can be hurt. But my love is still there. Are you understand what I'm saying? And so too is with the love of God. While we were yet sinners, he still died for us. So John 3:16 said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish but have life everlasting. So God's love is unconditional. He may not like what we do, and when we do wrong things, there are consequences. The wages of sin is death. The gift of God is eternal life. But God still loves us. Now, blessings is different. See, you could ask for a blessing. You could do the things that will cause you to be blessed. When you obey, you receive a blessing. When you disobey, you receive a curse. So if you're walking in obedience, you are walking in blessings. So the blessings is conditional, but not the love. Hallelujah. God don't love you when you do good things, and then he don't love you when you do bad things, and God don't love you. No. God is a God of change. God is not inconsistent. I might fail. I might fall. God still loved me. I'm not saying there are not consequences, but I'm saying God still loved me because I'm his child. Does he hate sin? Yes. But he don't hate the sinner. But we can obtain that blessing. Hallelujah. Now I want to take you into the book of Deuteronomy. Last week I gave you a chapter to read in Ezekiel chapter 18. All right. Where it talks about if they do the right thing, how they're going to be blessed. If they do the wrong thing, they'll receive a curse. But now let's look at Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. I'm reading from verses 1 through 5. And this will be your assignment when you get home. I want you to read this. You have the entire week to read Deuteronomy chapter 28. All right? Hear what it says. And it shall come to pass if. Do you know if it's conditional, right? If it's conditional. If I tell you, if I were to say, Sister Neela, Would you please, if you bring me a glass of water, I'm just drawing an illustration. If you bring me a glass of water, I will give you $100. Now, in order to get the $100, you got to bring the water. Because it's unconditional. If you don't bring the water, you don't get the $100. If you bring the water, you get the $100. If my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face, then that's conditional. Blessings are conditional, but not God's love. Are you with me? So now God is saying, if thou shalt do what? Hearken diligently unto my voice to observe to do all the commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all the nations of the earth. But before I set you above all the nations of the earth, you have to do what? You have to hearken diligently. And guess what will happen? And the blessing shall do what? Come unto thee and over thee. And if thou hearken unto my voice, to the voice of the Lord. Wow, that is awesome. That is powerful. Blessed thou shalt be in the city. Blessed thou shalt be in the field. Glory to God. Amen. Blessed shall thou be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, and the increase of thy kin, and the flock of thy sheep. Blessings after blessings. Blessed shall be in the basket. Blessed shall be in the store. Oh, glory to God. Listen, blessed thou shalt be when thou comest in, and blessed thou shalt be when thou goest out. I'm talking about the blessings of the Lord. Hallelujah. But it starts with, if thou will hearken diligently, and if thou will obey. Hallelujah. It's unconditioned. All right. I could read the entire chapter for you, but I want to continue at from verses 15. Verse 15. But it shall come to pass if thou wilt not hearken. You see, the Lord told Adam, the day that you eat of the fruit, thou shalt surely die. I still love you, but you shall die. There's consequences. The serpent came and said, thou shalt not surely die. And so it says, if thou will not hearken, there's a song that says, trust and obey. For there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. The obedient child shall taste the grace and eat the good of the land. To obey is better than to sacrifice, that to hearken unto the fats of ram. Amen. People like obedience. On the job, you go by the rules. If you go on the job and you try to change the rules, they might fire you. You go somewhere and you want to upset the apple cart. You want to bring your own way of doing things. You have to learn how to flow. You have to learn how to behave. You have to learn how to fit in. You have to learn how to mesh. Amen. If thou will, there are certain laws that we have to obey. There are traffic laws. There are real estate laws. There are different laws. It says, but if thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe and to do, all right, all his commandments and the statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. So again, we have a choice. Choose ye this day the God whom you may serve. There are consequences, my friend. Whatsoever a man sow, that shall he reap. If you sow to the flesh, you shall reap of the flesh corruption. And if you sow to the spirit, you shall reap of the spirit life everlasting. So compare from verses 1 through 15. And compare from verses 15 through the end of the chapter. It says, curse shall thou be in the city, and curse shall thou be in the field. Curse shall be thy basket and thy store. Cursed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy land, and the increase of thy kin, and the flock of thy sheep. See the very same thing that was said in the beginning of the chapter, we see it here in the middle of the chapter. One is has to do with obeying, and one has to do with disobeying. Hallelujah. What are we going to do? Cursed shalt thou be when thou comest in, and cursed when you're going out. I want to be blessed. And not only be blessed, I want to be a blessing. Do you know when you're a blessing to people, doors open up for you? God is able to make a way in the wilderness and rivers in a desert place. When you are a blessing, man, blessings will follow you. Blessings will flow after you. Amen. When you are free, the Bible says freely give, freely receive. When you are free in spirit, when you are free in mind, doors open up. When you're tight fist, when you're closed up, when you put a wall around you, there is nothing that can go in and come out. But amen, when you are open and free, things can flow. That's why a river flows. You know, last year, my wife and I visited the Niagara Falls. And it's a mystery. It's like an eighth wonder of the world. I looked at that thing. Amen. And I went there about 14 years ago. And it's still flowing. It's still flowing. I said, will it ever dry up? Will it ever stop? And I sat there and I said, where is this water coming from? 24/7, 365 days a year. It keeps flowing. It keeps flowing. That's what a river does. From the mountain where it melts the snow, it keeps flowing, flowing, flowing. Summer, winter, fall, spring. Amen. Since in the 90s, the 80s, it keeps flowing. And that's what it does. But a lake or a pond, it doesn't flow. Everything stays there and it can form a cesspool of contamination because there's no flow. Amen. I'm telling you, we have to understand the flow. We have to learn how to flow. The Lord teaches us how to flow. The woman with the pot of oil, that oil was flowing. The oil didn't stop flowing, is the vessels run out. And we have to learn how to flow in the supernatural and flow in the spirit and flow with kingdom principles. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, yeah. So I choose blessings, not curses. Hallelujah. I purpose. So this morning, I want to say to us, we are free. As I'm about to close, I want to go to Galatians. I think I read that last week, and I want to read it again. And we want to read it in the NIV. Now, it says in Ephesians 2 and 8 that we are saved by grace. If you could get that scripture for me, I didn't give it to you, but Ephesians 2 and 8. And then we're going to go to Galatians. We're going to do Galatians in the NLT. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A writer says, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for me, my soul cry, hallelujah, I thank God for saving me. God save you by grace when you believe. And you can't take credit for this. It is a gift from God. And it's so rightly how you sing that song, Brother Gerard, about God's grace. You are saved by grace when you believe. One version says, you are saved by grace through faith. Now we are saved from what? The curse. We are not cursed no more. We are blessed as children of God. I am redeemed. I am born again. I am saved. I am sanctified. I am filled. I am God's child. God loved me. Amen. Hallelujah. Now let's go to Galatians. Galatians, I'm reading from verses 9. Hallelujah. Chapter 3. So all who put their faith in Christ share the same blessing Abraham received because of his faith. Now, because of the blessings of Abraham, we also, as Gentiles, we will graft in. Now we are bought. Now we are spiritual Israelites. Hallelujah. But those who depend on the law to make them right with God are under his curse. See, the law could have only do so much. Under the law, you had to offer 2 turtle dove, a pair of pigeon, a lamb, a cow, a calf. Blood had to be shed annually, the Day of Atonement. But now, Jesus came and died once, and he died for all. That's why when John the Baptist saw him coming, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God that not only removed, but he takes away. He doesn't cover, he takes away the sins of the world." So now, watch this. It says, but those who depend on the law to make them right. You see, that's why he said the law killeth, but the Spirit giveth life. The law said do or die. The law was rigid. The law was stringent. The law could have only do so much. Watch this. Stay with me. This is good. All right? For the scripture says, cursed is everyone who does not observe and obey. You see the word obey come back again? All the commandments which are written in God's book of the law. 11. So it is clear that no one can be made right with God by trying to keep the law. Are you understand what I'm saying? By just trying to keep the law. For the scripture say, it is through faith that a righteous person has life. Amen. That's why it says the just shall do what? Live by faith. The just shall live by what? Not by the law, by faith. Glory to God. That's what the King James Version said. The just shall live by faith. Verse 12. This way of faith is very different from the way of the law, which says it is through obeying the law that a person has life, by obeying the law. But Christ has rescued us from the curse pronounced by the law. I am free. Who the Son set free is free indeed. I am not bound by tradition. I respect tradition, I respect culture, but I am free. Are you with me? So don't put yourself in bondage. And religious folks love to do that. And I'm religious to a point. I'm in church this morning, but I'm spiritual. I'm a Christian. I love God. But Christ has rescued us from the curse under the law. When he hung on the cross, he took upon himself the curse for our wrongdoing. So he took the curse. So the curse is placed on him. He died for me. He took the curse. For it is written in the scripture, curses everyone that hang on a tree. Verse 14. Through Christ, God has blessed the Gentile. Through Christ, what happened? I am blessed. Every day of my life, I am blessed. When I wake up in the morning, when I lay my head to rest, I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed in my going out and in my coming in. I am blessed. God opened doors for me. God favored me. When I think of the goodness of God, hallelujah, and all that he has done for me, my soul cry, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me. When I look where he brought me from, when I looked how he opened doors, when I looked how he favored me, when I looked how he blessed me, I don't mean to brag, I'm boasting in the Lord. God is good, and God is good all the time. Through Christ, God has blessed the Gentile with the same blessing he promised Abraham. You remember what I read to you earlier? Abraham, I will bless you. I will bless your generation. In you, all families of the earth shall be blessed. I will multiply your seed as the stars of the heaven, as the sand of the sea. I am grafted in. Now I am bought with a price. Jesus' blood is the remedy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the same promise that God gave Abraham, I got that promise. Hallelujah. I'm a child of the King. I am a peculiar people. I'm of a royal priesthood. I am called out of darkness into his marvelous light. Do you understand the promises? They are yea and amen. They are precious promises. A school teacher from Canada tried to, amen, get all the promises in the Bible, and they said there's over 2,000, 7,000 promises. We should sing a song growing up. Every promise in this book is mine. Every chapter, every verse, and every line. They are yea and amen. They are precious. So through Jesus Christ, God has blessed the Gentile with the same blessing he promised to Abraham, so that we are, who are believers. So listen to me. I'm not saying things can happen. We live on this planet Earth, but nobody could fix me. I ain't going by nobody for no bat. I ain't going by nobody to read my palm. People love that. The psychic industry is a $1 billion industry. And even in the church, it has come in the pulpit. I see this a young guy, he could be my son, almost want to say he could be my grandson. He is acting like some prophet, and people are, I'm saying, the guy's wet behind the ears. I'm saying, what's really going on here? And people are falling for it. They're running after a word. Hey, the promises is in the book. So I don't have to sprinkle no salt in front of my door. I don't need a squirrel tail. I don't need a rabbit claw. I don't need to pin something blue. I don't need to wear my underwear on the wrong side. Hallelujah. I'm a child of God. And when I get up in the morning and I fall on my knees and I say, Jesus, I lift my eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. No curse, no demon, no devil in hell. I don't need to see nobody. I don't need nobody to tell me anything. Amen. The Lord will lead me. The Lord will guide me. And the Lord will direct me. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. They send you by this one. They say, go see this one. Go see that one. People travel overseas. You'll be surprised. Looking for answers. You know, it was Saul. He went to the witch of Endor. He said, bring back Samuel to life. He was doing necromancy. He was messing with the dead. He was acting up in the cemetery. He was doing witchcraft and magic. There is no place for that in the kingdom of God. You stand on God's word. I am blessed and I'm not cursed. I decree and declare the blessings of God upon my life. And if God open a door, no man can shut. And who God bless, no man can curse. I don't need that. Jesus paid it all. Galatians 24. Let's jump a bit. You could read that one when you go home too. Wherefore the law was, what the law was? Our schoolmaster. I had a schoolmaster when I grew up. Jesus help us. I'm closing now. We have a teacher in the house here, Pastor Scott, who taught for the Board of Ed. And in those, back in the island, they would spank you. No, spank song to contemporary. They would put licks. And my school teacher, he had a strap, a leather strap. And when he tell you, put out your hand. Today, you can't do that in New York City here. The social worker will come get you. You're going to have a problem. But my schoolmaster, Mr. David, I was scared of him. They managed to play. And you can't go home and tell your mother, oh, mommy, Mr. David, she said, what? Let me give you some more. Today, you can't even, if you talk hard to a child, the mother come in school and want to fight the teacher. No. The children fighting the teacher, forget the mother. My Lord, how have we evolved? Wherefore the law was our schoolmaster. To bring us to do what? To bring us unto Christ. The schoolmaster will bring you. He will tell you, walk here, do this, do that, and then he brings you to Christ. That we might be justified by faith. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 25 says, but after that faith is come, we are no longer under the schoolmaster. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The day that Mr. David didn't come to school, I felt good. The schoolmaster wasn't there. For ye are children of God by faith through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I thank God this morning that I can walk in freedom and authority. And I thank God for all the blessings. Now, I'm not saying trials and tribulation will not come, but I thank God that I'm blessed with wisdom. I'm blessed with favor. I'm blessed with understanding. I'm blessed with money. I'm blessed with good friends. I'm blessed with a ministry. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. How many of you are blessed this morning? Don't let nobody define you and label you and call you names and tell you you're not amount to nothing. No. Send it back 7 different ways. You are blessed. You are a child of God. You are saved by grace through faith. Not of works, lest any man should boast. It is the grace of God. Hallelujah. I thank God for his grace. I tell you, the enemy wanted to kill me when I was a kid because he knew I was going to be a preacher. I was knocked down by a car twice. No broken bones, no concussion. Are you with me? And then God favored me even as a, I remember how God favored me. I mean, you could testify about the goodness of God. Some people don't want to talk about God's goodness. Hallelujah. I share my testimony, how God favored me when I came to this country. And you know, when I came here, I had no cousin, no auntie, no uncle, no cousin, no one. No, I came here like Abraham, I came here alone. I went for the visa the first time, boom, they give me the visa. Came to America, and when I came, I hope you're not tired of my story. They were sending back people. And the guy put my passport in a red pouch. And they sent me to a room. And in the room, people were crying. I said, Lord Jesus. And they brought me out. They said, raise up your neck. Raise up your, look up. Said, yes, sir. So where are you going? I said, I'm going to Connecticut. By who? I told him by who. He watch up, he watch down, and he stamped my book. By the way, before I left Trinidad, we kept the farewell. Have you seen the movie Going to America? Coming to America, not going, coming. Thank God they didn't send me back on that flight. And when I went from the green card, Pastor Hunt, her birthday is next week. That's my mother, 33 years ago. When we went to the interview, we forget one of the most important documents home. I met a tall African-American lady. And she looked through everything. Said, isn't that favor? In 4 months' time, I got a green card. Brother Willie, I don't know if you understand what green card. You were born here. You know what it is to get a green card, brother? I was crying from Washington to New York on the Greyhound bus. Tears of joy. I came here, nobody. And in 4 months' time, God blessed me and God favored me. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, I didn't have to bribe nobody, pay nobody. Amen. God made a way in the wilderness and rivers in a desert place. Look what God, but God. Hallelujah. Blessings. In 1990, I was working for Brooklyn Baller. This brother who worked together with me, he bought two applications for sanitation. In those days, you didn't apply online. We didn't have online in those days. You fill the hard copy out and you send it in. And he was not accepted, and they accepted mine. And out of some 200,000 people, they called my name. Could somebody say favor? Can I talk about God's goodness? And for me to hate now, after all that God has done for me to hate, hate is too heavy a burden to carry. For me now to walk in unforgiveness and to hold a grudge and to hold an envy and to hold a malice. When God said, I will bless you, I will make you a blessing. Hallelujah. This building, we bought this building for $160,000. We was getting kicked out from the storefront. Deacon Eiffel, you know, we was getting kicked out from the storefront. And I tried to slow them down. And I tried to stall them so we can move here and God give us favor. Somebody say favor. Somebody say favor. So I refuse. I refuse for anybody to speak a curse over my life. I am covered under the blood of Jesus. I am sanctified. I'm saved. I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm a child of the Most High God. Look, it's truly, I didn't intend to talk like this. But God is good. How many, God is good. God is faithful. I thank God. Keeping me. I'm not on any medication. Turned 61. Thank God. All I want to do is serve God and love people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No hang-ups. I'm free. Who the Son says free is what? Free indeed. When you're not free in spirit, you block your way. Hey, Isaac, in the same chapter 26, Isaac showed in the time of famine, and God gave him 100-fold. He took that from his father Abraham. He sowed. He blessed in the time of farming. That's when everybody's trying to hold on to what they have. He sowed, and the wells were unclogged, and the wells will begin to spring and begin to flow because he sowed a seed. Hallelujah. And the seed gave him a harvest, and the Lord blessed him 100-fold. Be a blessing. Don't be a burden. Stand, everybody. I didn't intend to go this late, this long. We usually finish, but God is good. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your blessings, your favor. Oh, glory to God. Jabez said, bless me. listen to Jabez. Let's listen to the first. What is it? Chronicles. Is it Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9 and 10? Hallelujah. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. He wasn't a con artist. That's why I tell people, don't matter. Listen, the curse is broken. And that was back under the law, and that was in the Old Testament. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him in sorrow. Names are significant. Names are significant. And Jabez called on God of Israel, saying, O God, that thou would bless me indeed. Enlarge my coast, and thy hand might be upon me, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil, and it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he requested. Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, sometime you gotta speak, you gotta vocalize, you gotta pronounce it, you gotta decree it, you gotta declare it, you gotta say it, you gotta vocalize it. You got to speak in the atmosphere. You got to speak through the airwaves and tell God what you want. We used to sing a song, Jesus is on the main line. Tell him what you want. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And God granted him his request. Today I want to speak right now in the name of Jesus. Today I want to prophesy right now. I want to speak a blessing right now. I take authority in the name of Jesus, and I decree and declare a thing, and I believe God will establish it. I speak over my wife today. I speak over my children. I speak over the church. I speak over the leadership. I speak over the musicians. I speak over the media team. I speak over this building. I speak over this community. I speak over the airwaves, a blessing. Bless us in our going out and bless us in our coming in. We come against the works of the enemy. We come against any plan of the enemy. We reverse it. We cancel it. We send it back seven different ways. We walk in freedom. We walk in authority. We walk in boldness. We walk in victory in the name of Jesus. It's not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. I am above and not beneath. I am blessed and not cursed. Hallelujah. I am above. Glory. I shall lend and not borrow. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I am a victor and not a victim. I'm a child of God. Whatever you put your hands to, it shall prosper. Wherever your feet shall tread, it shall be yours. We can speak like Amen Caleb at 85. He said, give me my mountain. This is my inheritance. It belongs to me. Come on, stand on the promises of God. They are yea and amen to them that believe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. Listen to me. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. The Lord has spoken to your heart to do something. Do it. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. Be a blessing. And blessings has a way of returning. When you cast your bread in the waters, after some days, it's coming back. Somebody says, it's not just coming back like bread. It's coming back with a piece of cheese and some butter on it. Hallelujah. Cast it. Don't hold it. Don't hold it. Cast it. Give it. Let it flow. It may leave your hands, but not your life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I feel the anointing in the house today. Something is about a break. Something is about a give in the supernatural. Hallelujah. Thank you for your blessings. We're not dealing with the curses this morning. We're going to break some things here in the name of Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Some of you will be the first one to buy a house in your generation. The first one to get married. The first one to get a degree. The first one, hallelujah, to graduate college. Amen. The first one to open a business. The first one. You're going to be the first one. You're going to be a trendsetter, a world changer. Hallelujah. You will be a go-getter. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Doors about to open. Amen. Trails about to be opened up. Tracks, amen, about to be clear for you to run and for you to flow in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. He comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus has come that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Do you know you're a child of God? Do you know you are a peculiar people, a royal priesthood, a chosen generation? Glory to God. God has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, we thank you. In Jesus' name. I claim the blessings of Abraham, the blessings of Isaac, the blessings of Jacob, the blessings of Joseph. Blessings after blessings. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Hallelujah. Come, brother Willie, let's receive an offering.
Thanks, thanks. I give you thanks for all. I am so blessed.
My soul.
My soul is at rest. Oh Lord, I give you thanks. Oh, thanks.
Thank you, Lord.
I give you thanks.
For all.
For all you.
All you have done. Thankful, okay? I want you to be thankful. The Bible said, in everything give God thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. I may believe you're blessed this morning. Somebody once said, I'm too blessed to be stressed. They say stress can trigger off certain disease in your life. Hypertension, cancer, all kind of things. I am blessed. Free in spirit, in my heart. The Lord told Samuel, he said, man look on the outward appearance, but I look on the heart. Glory to God. Glory to God. God bless you today, and God keep you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Pastor Brown, will you come and just say a prayer as we close today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Oh, God is good. God is good. You hear me?
Hallelujah. Father and God, we thank thee for your word today, Lord. Your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. We thank you, oh God, for each and every one of us here. Today we thank God because we know we are blessed today.
Yeah.
And we could walk in faith. We could walk in joy. We could walk in peace. We could walk in harmony. We thank you today, Lord, for your blessing, Lord. We thank you for each and every one of us here this morning, oh God. Help us, we walk out these doors, that we may step out in faith this morning. And let them know that you is a God who is able to do all things. You are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we could ask. We thank you for your blessing today. We ask, oh God, as this week is set before us, journey before us,
oh,
Lord.
Yes.
Go before us today, Lord, Father, and keep us in thy ways today. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name.
Amen,
amen and amen.
The favor of God is upon me. Let the devil know that I am a winner. The favor of God is upon me. Let the devil know that I am a winner.
I am a winner.
Oh yes,
I am a winner.
Oh, let the devil know that I am a winner.
Sing it again.
I am a winner.
Oh yes,
I am a winner. Oh,
let the devil know that
I am a winner.
The favor
of God
is upon me. Say yes. Say yes. Oh, you sound like you didn't have breakfast. Say yes.
Yes.
Say yes.
Yes.
All right. God bless you. Amen.